Hello, welcome to another Craft Time at the Mascent Regional Library. I'm Miss Stephanie, one of the children's librarians here. And for this month, I'm pleased to show you that we are going to learn how to make a balloon game. And this balloon game is going to look a little like this. And what it is we're gonna like blow through the straw and try to keep the balloon up in the air as much as you can. Now, to get the materials for this kit, you just need to go to your closest MRL branch and pick up one of our craft kits. And if you have trouble finding them, just make sure that you talk to one of the librarians here. Now, let's get started on making our balloon game. And here are the list of materials you're going to need for this craft. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take your white cardstock piece, and you are going to take the CD, or if, like, I just found an old CD in the back room. If you have like an old scratched up CD or just something that's kind of a similar size, you can use it to make the base. And what we're going to do now is we're going to put the CD on the paper, and the next thing we will do is I'm going to trace a circle. And then once I've traced that circle, what I will do is cut it out. So let's cut out the circle. And just take a couple minutes to do it. And then there we go. And before we do our next step, you can, if you want to, you can color your circle whatever color you want. I have some markers here. I'm just gonna make a couple stripes. You can do it on one side, or you can flip it over and do it on both sides. It's whatever you would like to do. And so I'm just gonna make just a couple marks here, and I'll do one across. Just like, because purple is actually one of my favorite colors. So that's why I chose that. And then let's do some blue. And there we go. Okay, so then the next thing we want to do is we want to take your pencil, or if you can't see it because of what you're coloring, take a black marker, which I will do, and put a dot in the center of your circle like this. Then you will take your scissors and you're going to cut until you get to the center of the, to the dot. You're going to like cut from the edge to the center. You're not going to cut all the way through. So let me, all right, there we go. Now the next step we're going to do, we have our slit. We're going to kind of make it into a funnel shape. And this may be a little tricky. Make some practice. Like, what you're going to do is you're going to take one end and fold it under the other like this. And you kind of, it'll look a little like this. And what we'll do is once you have that shape is take some tape, take one piece of tape and put it on the outside of the funnel shape. And then we'll take another piece of tape, and just to make sure it's extra secure, and put it on the inside. Okay, so then what you're gonna do next is you're gonna take your scissors, and you're gonna make a very small hole you're gonna snip off the end of the funnel to make a small hole for your straw to go through. And it's better to just start small and then make it slowly bigger, because you can always make your slit bigger, but you can't, once you've cut it, you can't exactly make it smaller again. So let me see if my straw will fit through here. And it will, so I don't have to do anything. Now, you want to have it fairly low into the funnel shape. You can see right here, like my straw is kind of low in here. And hold it, and you may take some practice. Like, I'm having a little trouble because the straw keeps wanting to slip up. But if you stick your straw too far up in here, your balloon's not going to be able to settle into the funnel, and you can't really play your game that way. So we'll just go back down here. I'm going to hold it steady. And then I'm going to take some tape, and it's better to use a lot of tape for this just to make sure that the straw stays exactly where you want it to in the funnel. on. So tape some here, press it, make sure it's firm, and then check to make sure that the straw is not wiggling around, which mine isn't. So then there you have it. There is the part of the game, first part of the game. And then the next part is to blow up the balloon and use it. And let me move the camera so you can see exactly how that's gonna work. The last step we need to do is we need to get our balloon out and let's blow it up. And you don't want to make it too big, but if you want a challenge, you can make it bigger. I'm going to make it a little on the smaller side, because so you just want to make sure that it's going to fit in your funnel. So then I'm going to tie the end. Okay, make sure it's secure so it doesn't leak. Then take your funnel piece, put the balloon in. Just blow through the straw and just then see how long you can keep it in the air. And you can just kind of want to experiment with it a little bit, use different balloon sizes, but anything, you're not going to get anything heavier than a balloon to come up in this. So just a balloon would be the best thing to use for this particular game. So, and also I wanted to share a couple books with you about kind of related to that if you wanted to make some additional games. Because winter's coming and it's kind of cold outside, so if you want something to do, you can make your own games about materials that you find in your home. And the first one, this is more of like cardboard and duct tape crafts, but there was a craft inside that I wanted to show you that you could possibly make, and it's a ring toss cap game. And what you do is you just take a egg carton and you can color it, and then use like those little milk round things, the tabs off of the milk cartons, or you can, if you have pipe cleaners at home, you can twist them together and you can make your very own milk. And this book is called Put on a Show with Cardboard and Duct Tape, and it is written by Leslie Manlapke. And then the second book that I'm going to show you today is like, this is how to make board games in general, and I'm a person who really loves playing board games, so I was really excited to get this book. And it's called Cool Board Games, Crafting Creative Toys and Amazing Games. And the author of this is Rebecca Felix. And there's a lot of really cool ones in here, but since one of my favorite games is Scrabble, I'll just show you that one. And this one is called Refrigerator Words. And it's where you can use different markers and paints and like little round magnets to create your own magnetic Scrabble game on your fridge. So, and the materials, like, they're pretty much a couple things you might have to go out or ask your adult to get, but most of it is just stuff that you can find around your house. So I would highly recommend either one of these books if you're interested in making some more games for you or your friends or siblings to play with. So thank you again for joining us for a craft video. I look forward to sharing another craft with you next month. Have a good day. Bye.